Mo was repeatedly offered flattering contracts to perform in English theatres, but he was loyal to the country of his birth. He felt that he was one of us, and we should be grateful that his ambitions didn't deprive us of the many years of laughter he gave us, such as in this Mccackie mansion.
Where are you, Dad? Hey, Dan, there's a letter here from our butcher. He says you haven't paid your bill for 6 months.
The cheeky possum. He ordered out my system of paying bills. Every month I put all my accounts into a hat, shuffle them up, draw out three and pay them. And if that flaming butcher isn't careful, he won't even get into next month's shuffle. Anyhow, I should worry. I got a new butcher, Angus McAllister McCavish.
Oh, he's a Scotchman, eh?
Yes, and he specializes in his national dish, Scotch pheasant.
What's a Scotch pheasant, Dad?
It's saveloy with a feather on it.
I suppose you spend all your time looking in his window, do you?
Don't be silly, Harry. What would I look like with me face stuck in a butcher's shop window?
A pig's head.
Harry, cop this.
Oh. Hello, Maui.
It's Honorable Herbie. Honorable, I've got to give you a home-cooked meal. I've got to cook myself.
Oh, Steve, I bet you'll taste awful.
Honorable, you're just a brewer. Nothing but a brewer.
What's a brewer?
A backward warp.
Peek-a-boo, everybody. It's little me, Spencer the Garbage Man.
Oh, it's Spencer. Come in, Spencer, dear, and sit under the electric fan.
My, Mr. McPhee. What's that delicious aroma I can smell?
Well, it isn't you. If you must know, Spence, I'm preparing a home-cooked meal. I got some meat from a new butcher, Angus McAllister McTavish.
Hey, Moe, how do you and this Scotch butcher come to be so matey?
Well, he likes me because I can talk his language. It's a broad black nick and nick. Oi, 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 muzzle top.
Where did you learn to speak that, Mr. McPhee?
In the Highlands.
Where's the Highlands?
Anywhere where Spencer is. Oh, phew!
My Uncle Harrico is the living image of a famous historical figure.
Who's Spence? Bonny Prince Charlie?
No, Bonnie Black Bess.
My butcher Spence, he's a real Scotsman. He specializes in tartan sausages. Oh, it's Mr. Nashwood. Every time I see him, I get a pain in my lamb's fly. You better scram, Lasho. The mum and I are just going to eat.
Oh, McCackie. And you're gonna sink your fork into the lobster more now.
No. I'm gonna sink my nose into the malakatari. Barracuda.
Hey, Mr. Lashwood, did you know that Maui has a Scotch butcher that sells everything?
Oh, has he now? Oh, well, that butcher must be very much like you, McCackie.
In what way, Lasho?
Plenty of meat on his hook.
Oh, very witty, very witty. Oh, that's clever. I do enjoy a joke at my own expense, really, I do. Get out, chipmunk, get out.
Mr. McPhee, how did you discover this Caledonian meat emporium?
Well, I walked right into the shop. He stole a kiss from a pretty little thing behind the counter.
Oh, Struth, I bet that was nice.
Not Denny. It was Mr. McTavish wearing his kilt.
A Scotch butcher, eh? Has he got an haggis?
Well, if he has, he never wears it.
No, Mccackie. What's that fat ball of meat he keeps wrapped up in a bag?
His mother-in-law. Are you fond of meat, Spence?
Oh, yes, Mr. McSee. I can be very savage to a saveloy.
Cannibal? Personally, I come from a long line of vegetarians.
Oh, my God! Does your family eat raw nuts and keep to a diet?
No, no. They ate raw onions and kept to themselves. Stink pumpkin.
Hey, Maui, what's your recipe for cooking meat?
Well, I pour out the meat in a bottle of sherry, a bottle of port, and a bottle of Bombay.
Oh, gee, does that make the meat taste tender?
I don't know, but the gravy's lovely. Well, come on, Bob, into the kitchen. Ah, here we are, a special pot roast is provided by Mr. Angus McTavish. Now, here's a little bit for you, and a little bit for you.
Thank you.
And a dirty big whack for me.
It tastes rather unusual, doesn't it?
Well, personally, I think it's tough.
Let's have a look at it. The dirty mug.
Why, Mccackie, what have we been eating?
Mr. McTavish's sporum.